It's a privilege and an honor, of course, to manage 1,000 games in the same club. And between the moment I met David Dean and he introduced me to Peter Hillwood, of course, a lot has happened at this club. But I must say, for such a long time, the club has always supported me, and I feel really that I'm privileged in that, because that's not always usual in our game. And we have gone through difficult and fantastic periods, but always remained focused on being united at this club. And that's why I think I acted always in with three things in my mind. The first one is that every decision I make is like I own the club. That's always in the interest of the club first. The second is that I think I am in a job where you need to have a clear perception of your ideas and have the courage to transform it into actions. And the third that has always guided me is that to make this club grow and make sure that the club is bigger when I leave, when I arrived. And time will tell if I manage to do that, but I hope so. Look, there have been many, and I cannot classify the moments of happiness and of sadness. But what is for sure is that you never forget. Every defeat is a scar in your heart that you never forget. And the happiness you forget quickly, because you find it normal, because that's what you work for. And unfortunately, there's a lot of suffering as well in 1,000 games. And what is for sure is that what you want is the next moment of happiness. That means you're always expecting the next game. And the next game, hopefully, will be a moment of happiness.
I guess the fans will want to know, how far into your second 1,000 of games do you think you'll go here at Arsenal?
I'm an idealist, but not fool, you know, as well, so, but not crazy. So it is I am in at a stage of my career where I'm extremely passionate, maybe more than ever, to do well for this club, but I have to accept that the next 1,000 will be difficult.
As we were saying, 1,000 games is an incredible achievement, but is the statistic that you need to change the most the fact that it's now been 502 matches since Arsenal won a trophy? Is that what's going on?
Yes, but I can take a distance with that, you know, because if winning a trophy is win a League Cup and finish 12 in the league, I think the most important thing for the quality of a club, of the management of a club, is the consistency of the achievement. After the trophies come and go, but I believe you see the quality of the management inside the club is the consistency of the achievement. If you finish 1 year first and the second year 12th, I don't believe that the real quality of management is linked with consistency. After, of course, we want to win trophies, but I think if you look well at the consistency we have shown in the last 15 or 17 years and you compare with all other clubs, that is the most difficult to achieve. In individually, finals, it's great players that win you the games, and we have great players, so I'm confident we can win trophies. It is the game of the season for us. It's as simple as that, because we are in a period where every point is vital now, and especially against your direct opponents. It is for us the most important game of the season now. The team's advantage is the performance on the pitch. You know, press conferences can be for you more or less boring, and I can understand that you like some more than others, but the real excitement is the game. And the game is on the pitch.
For example, he says Chelsea aren't favourites, even though they're clear at the top.
Well, you cannot say that they are not favourites or favourites. They are amongst the team who fights to win the Premier League. Nobody can deny that, you know. And if you look at the table, what is very interesting, it is you have Chelsea, you have Man City, you have Liverpool, and you have Arsenal. And that has not happened for years to fight for the Premiership. That makes it really interesting. Nobody of these four teams can say they are not going for it. That would be stupid.
How do you feel about taking on Jose Mourinho again after he made that remark about you being a specialist?
Well, I would keep that for myself. You know, tomorrow I represent my club. I don't represent myself, and I will behave always in respecting the values of our club and keep my own feelings far away from that.